Clearly, thought it was like forever.
It is July 2023. Wow, dog. Great. And we have 1 more minute, and then we'll never be June drops, dog.
Yo, 1 more minute. Ma. Hey, no way.
Yo. Expose Spotify ads. Yo, crazy.
Yo, exposure.
Don't do this to my release date. Your pork ass, dude.
Yo.
No.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh no, it hasn't changed yet.
It hasn't changed. Why were you even counting those?
I don't know. Just next song. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let me stream it on my phone. I have it on.
Everyone is streaming, dog.
Nigga, I got it.
Yes. Oh yeah.
It's out.
Yeah.
Ads, dog, is going to still kill.
Oh my God, look at him.
Hey Earl, I hope you're doing well. So I just wanted to encourage you a little bit and say I've seen that you've grown so much. I think you just need to keep going, keep fighting, keep pushing everyone that's around you.
Okay, are you ready? Okay, let's do it again. Let's do it 2 more times.
Fucking walk on my own, finally ready to act.
What I said.
You are an embarrassment.
Did
you? I don't know, Shay.
What are you stressed about?
Tell us something inspiring.
Oh, did you know when I got your call?
Tell her to send pictures, dog.
No way, right now. So.
Away.
Hey, dog. Yo.
It's for science, dog. It's for science.
After hitting her up, we ended up starting to work, and that's when we. Okay, I don't think they know about this issue, man.
Light skinned and super smart.
The omnipotent voice of Earl is back. Quite sick. But this is very important because we're talking about the 3 stages, the 3 years that took us to make Will Never Be June. So here we are.
That's the only thing I like.
If it's attached to bums, though.
Jiggy, are you coming on?
Yeah.
In this dip.
Put up with the air, isn't it?
Yeah, dog.
Of course. Poverty, you know.
Yeah.
The guy that just out here in the situation.
Ah, my angle.
Yeah, but you know how it is.
Yeah, man, we just come from a 3-day session, you know.
Just come from 3 sessions, playlist house, you know how it is.
Right after Prologue, we were inspired by the idea of working on another project in the same year. So 2021 led us to inventing a new project that we thought would finish in a couple of months.
And it led us here.
So you thought you were a comedian when you were praying, eh? Let's see how fun it is when you're banning.
Closing off 2021, we got straight into a session trying to work on this new project that we thought would come straight after Prologue. One thing that I didn't know at the time was that when working on a project, there's going to be times where ideas change. We worked on songs like Holding On, thinking that this was going to be the new pioneer sound we're going to work on.
You walk out wearing them white jeans, and you're like, yo.
We drive fast, it's blurry up on my dash. I struggle to see the signs of.
if I strap with them, I'm gonna crash. This is crappy.
Escape responsibility, but a beautiful thing that you can always take time to do is, what if it works out better than we ever thought?
What if it doesn't? What if it does?
But what if it doesn't?
Yeah, there's that. What if it does? What if it's triple whatever you thought it was ever gonna be? Then what do you do?
I think in such situations, all you can do is just go.
Yeah, that's all we can. I'm already this deep in there.
You just gotta put the work in and trust God.
And we pray and stuff like that. Imagine, Jesus, I trust you. However, I'm gonna do these precautionary things in case you fail me.
I just need a worldly backup plan.
I just need a backup plan, Jesus, because hey, it's all these things, I can trust you.
I can trust you, but hey,
however, hey,
there's limits to this thing.
You always have to have something that stops you from.
You know, God.
You always have a plan B. Is that so funny, though? I mean, it's good to have a plan B, but hey, how can we plan and say, God, I trust you with everything. However,
this one particular matter.
One particular matter, I don't fully trust you. I like to say I do, but hey.
It's easier to say I do, but
if you
hey.
Let me down, Jesus, hey, I won't be able to recover financially, so hey. Let me not take chances.
Right. It's officially Saturday now, and the time is midnight, half past midnight. There's my boy Duncan right there, working hard as usual. And my assistant right there, unpaid intern. And yes, we're now going to finish off another song for this unnamed project.
I did someone's hair.
She did hair the whole session. Shout out to her. She didn't do my hair though. That's why the beanie. It's a movie out here. Oh, she actually tore my hair out.
I found it.
Yeah. Over what? Anyways, yes, the session ends technically today, but it's tomorrow whenever sun rises, and then we're driving back to Boxburg to drop off Don Corleone and Foslu to draw the boys, and then the session will officially be over. And 2022 will begin. Yes. I am tired. It's been a long
time. We're just recording until switches off.
Fine boy.
After making Prologue, we had a ritual process where we played the project we made to our families. And after the quote-unquote project we had finished, we played it for our family. And safe to say, there were some anxieties about what we've done because the reaction wasn't as pretty as we thought.
Everybody likes it. Unless they were lying to us, but I mean, it looked genuine, so we're going to believe it.
Yeah.
It's genuine.
All right, guys. We're at the conclusion. I'll say something inspiring, guys.
We're done, dog. We're not done, bro. The album is far from finished, dog.
And I am moral support.
Yes, we're just beginning. Where are we?
We're not done. We played the album for the ends.
Can't focus on my face. Focus on my bloody face, damn it.
I just keep satisfied.
Oh, you just have to deal with the blurriness. Either way, yes. And now we're gonna continue.
Wait, I didn't show. In my forehead, I show it. Wait, it's not coming.
The work has only beginning.
Hi.
Hi, man.
It's been a mori.
As of where?
Hey guys, we're currently in the mud right now.
Oh yeah, oh shit, yeah, that's good. Yeah.
Currently, before the blow up,
the misadventures of Earl and Nash.
You paid all right, you didn't pay one.
Yeah, it's been money.
You paid like, we're on our way home now.
And remember, ladies, send your CVs to my dear.
Don't hail, but my Harris doesn't have the grip to drive us home. But...
Here's Faye with the snacks.
As artists, we spend a lot of time looking for inspiration, but sometimes that inspiration comes to find us. while aimlessly looking for some grand gesture for this project we're working on, I went through a period of life that made me realize what I did want to talk about if I were to make a project. Certain feelings and experiences and being in certain places made me feel like I finally had something very important to say. And I wasn't going to make music for music's sake, but make music to express a certain feeling that I hoped would help a lot of people. Will Never Be June is a love letter to my perseverance, but also a great thank you to everybody who was there for me in a period where I didn't think I would be able to make art like this ever again. So everything I do now is right. Just a glowing manifestation of that.
I didn't think this through. Give me a second. Okay, never mind.
Yeah. Right, guys, we're here. Document never everything. Good gang.
It's the last days, you know.
The final days. But before we go.
Hello!
What are we planning today, Ben? What are we planning today?
Progress on the project.
Yes. How far are we?
We're almost done. Like, we're 85% of the way there.
Alright. No, that's good.
Yeah, man. You know, this is the executive producer around here.
Executive
producer. It's like 8 songs so far, if I'm not mistaken. No. Yeah, but we're getting
the inspiration, the lifelight of the project. Mm.
Now we are exporting into Emma's files.
I don't care. You're feeling this song way too.
It's a corny way of going about making art, but for me, a very big inspiration is how I feel in my heart at a certain point when I'm making music. In the period that I started focusing on the idea of Will Never Be June as a fully fleshed out idea, I was in a state where I was very miserable and heartbroken. And I think that meeting up with my friends who brought this level of happiness out of me, because we all related to one thing that we love to do, that's music. Jiggy Stapes, again, my favorite producer, was leading the charge for making this project. And as I grew as a person, as an artist, so did he. And that led us to a breakthrough period where we were just churning out great music over and over and over again. There's nothing more inspiring than finally having a vision for yourself and pursuing it.
Wow, that was such a roller coaster.
That was a waste of fuel. Because we didn't
today was just us ordering the project.
Yeah, apparently it's done over.
It's done over.
Oh, I've left us to listen to a Kendrick album, though. Kendrick! Yeah,
Kendrick will just force you to start all over.
Kendrick could have sing.
He's the real definition of burn that hard drive.
He could have made us burn that hard drive.
That's part of the story, that literally we had the project done, then we listened to Kendrick, and then we burnt that.
No way, we can't be.
Months before he said that verse, we were already burn that hard drive.
We burned that hard drive. We started again. We are back again.
Yes, sir.
To finish the project.
We thought we were done, but no.
It was a lie.
Round two.
And we have our co-writer in here, Nashi. How do you feel, Nashi?
I also should start getting co-writer like credits, to be quite honest. And if
you need to be quiet, dog.
If you get called, if this guy gets called, you know, credits, all of us should.
All of us.
What do you mean?
All of us.
Inflation. Now everyone has a writing credit, dog.
Okay, it's fine.
You see, so
yeah. Not about to do that, dog. Nah, leave me alone. I don't want to be.
That's like saying
we're setting up a studio.
And a piano there, and you're like, I need to get a production.
All right. This video is not sponsored by Nature Valley. We are now going to start working on finishing this project like we should have the first time. We thought we did, but we did not. So now we have everyone in session. My boy Nash is here. Alicia over there. Banana is sitting over there. You won't see his ass. Let me turn it for you. There he is. And my man Wesley in the back. So now we are focused on Hawa. We are focused on Will Never Be June, the ending, the outro. So
But ladies and gentlemen, take a seat. Drink all the water you need to. Screw these bitches. And let's make this money.
Yo!
Capella in 777 was a very important song in terms of, for me, diverting from what I usually do and pushing myself further as an artist. Without the help of Wesley as well as Jiggy, the vision wouldn't have been able to come out as fluid as it did. The song was very crucial, coming second on the project, because it expresses a very raw and angry emotion that I felt in a way and a style that I didn't feel was very represented in the genre and the line of work that I was in.
Yeah, if it's going to be on top, I feel like it's going to have tension. Yeah, or maybe it's going to like... Don't try to save me. Ain't coming home.
Yeah.
I really want to do something crazy. I'm going to watch Lord of the Rings. You have a charger for you.
We just finished the first day in this finish up session. And now we are going to sleep because we ran out of ideas. Stay inspired, keep working hard.
Alright, gentlemen, it's a new day, it's a new hour. Let's get this whole wheat bread. I got it for some gold on Instagram.
Yeah, no one did last in the 10 seconds.
Yeah. She was like, she says, let's get this whole wheat bread.
Day two of the session had come along, and this was the day where, in a very spontaneous and random moment, we created forever. But at first, the idea and the chords from Nasha were ignored, until Jiggy had a sample drum pack that he really, really, really wanted to use. So we found a way of making both of them work together.
I don't want to let it go.
And this is all that came out.
I came at this part. Because I thought this, the I played.
Well, of course, the last play.
Yeah.
Wait, sorry, let's do it. Let's get it.
Can we connect the.
Yeah. Record it. Let me state in there. And then we, most in the future, some director will pop up and say, I know I'm there. What are you supposed to give him?
I was there.
I was there.
Yeah.
I was like, all right, boys, what are we doing today? It might come as a surprise to a lot of people, but during this period in mid-2022, I was very new to rapping, and I knew that if I was going to release a new project, I really wanted to try this new style. And if I was going to try it on any song, it would have to be this idea. It would have to be this moment, and it would have to be then. So as a person who's transitioning from more R&B to hip-hop, it was a very
simple bridge when you're putting in the environment the right artists. African, you forget that load shedding is gonna happen. And in one night we had this crazy load shedding and we burst into a stereotypical African worship session that to me felt more than just pretend. If you put a bunch of guys in a room together who all learn to play music from church, don't be surprised if they break into a beautiful worship session in the middle of the night. The lyrics.
Maybe it's
good.
I don't know.
Gay.
When I'm feeling uninvited, what I needed, couldn't have it. I can't help it. I'm not selfish. Needed loving. Don't abandon me, don't abandon me.
Perfect.
Who's here? Wow! Wow! Do you think we'll last forever? I just need to know. But I'll let it bleed forever.
So the first one is na 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 na
na na na na na na na na na na na na na na na na na na na
na na na na na
na
na
na na
na
na na na na na na na na na
na na na na
In my heart, I'll let it bleed forever. I just need to know.
So if we drop,
hold on 1 second. What time is it?
It's really late.
It's 5 o'clock in the morning.
How are you?
Hmm?
How are you?
Okay. Nashe, can you get us like some to wipe the plates?
Oh, excuse my beard, dog. I haven't even combed it. I'm telling you, the minute this thing connects, dog.
There was a white girl who once asked me, do black people grow beards? I was like,
yeah? Who was this white girl?
Wesley doesn't just play piano. Wesley snipes.
He's snapping. No, that's it. Wesley sings. Said you don't hear him. He's singing every day. I said, I don't know. So he came and he was walking through the chairs. You know, he's the restaurant. So he's walking through the chairs. He and I, and then,
How old was he?
As much as all my friends are my colleagues and people I go to work with, they're just as much a part of my family. Making music for me is where I share that blood with them. I feel very privileged to be able to make a video like this where I feel like my friends were celebrating me, but in this moment I get to celebrate them. People will make you feel like, damn, I'm so lucky to have them, and they trigger almost a level of imposter syndrome every time I think about how lucky I am to have everyone in my life.
Here we go again.
It was my 21st birthday, and I experienced my first ever surprise party. My friends didn't think I was surprised at the time, but I genuinely was, seeing a lot of people's faces who I didn't expect, especially Duncan. Duncan, my favorite sweetheart, Duncan. These are experiences that drive me a lot. I think back on them very fondly, and sharing them is like me opening up a part of myself I don't usually show to a lot of people, but to a lot of people who want to be a part of my process and understand what goes through my head when I make music, it's these moments that don't have luxurious chains or tons of money or fast cars. It's just people I really like. I didn't make friends with all of them just at once. It was one by one. I met one guy, next year I meet another guy. Next year I meet another guy, and one day when you just take a big look back, you realize, oh shit, that's a lot of people. So it's difficult to incorporate when making will never be June and not incorporating this very core memory that I had.
Yeah, that's the way.
Because quarters are high in nutritional value, high in fiber. They're very healthy for the growing black man. We're doing another session now. Panel is not here because he's at home. Because he couldn't handle the smoke. What we're going to be doing today, we're going to spend the next 3 days. The day today is December 6th. The sickest. And we're going to be going back to my house to try and finish off We'll Never Be June without him.
How can you do this to us, dog?
How can you do?
Alright guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today he's asking me, what are we doing? And today we're gonna go eat. Are we getting quotas, guys?
We just get quotas, dog.
I said, are we? Alright, let's go eat.
Tea, as in tea.
Yeah, like tea, just tea, just the tea.
Can I get another gift? Sweet, yeah.
This beat is crazy, Doug.
Did you know?
His braces.
Yeah, I was on slap, so.
It sounds like the last piece, though. Hey, isn't that it?
Hello, Mr. Leisure.
We are on the set of making real life pornography. With jiggy steps.
Show us the drip.
Show us that AM drip, dog.
The AM drip. That employed man drip. Dog, show me a bit. I want to see if there's any lotion or tissues there. That's why the lights were off, dog.
Yeah.
That's why. You shake, dog. Like. It takes maybe 30 minutes, dog. But too much self-exposure. This part won't make it into the documentary. Yeah. Anyway. Okay, bye, Ban Ban.
Make sure you sleep, dog, and get enough rest. Tomorrow's a new day.
Yeah, the neighbors think I'm selling dope. Huh. I just say I'm selling hope. Huh. I just say I'm selling hope. Okay.
You know this dance by Donald Trump? This guy, he was jerking off ghosts.
That trick got me in great time. And they were like, do you want to taste the magic trick? I was like, yeah. And they're like, if you do this, you can actually taste the salt pepper. And I was like,
yeah. You were like, no.
Can you taste the salt and pepper? I was like, yeah, I can. Alright, let's go.
Recording again.
Yeah, it's gonna put some mesh. Psst, shut up.
Psst. You done? Hey, look at, and I'm not even aware of it. Really, I almost got it the first one.
Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to talk about why it's important after a session to take time to beat your meat. You see, usually for me when I'm stressed, I don't do that because I'm not a sinner like you. You thought this was some kind of disgusting message, but no. It's a very Christian message. Today, we just finished the second song. And now Wesley and Jiggy are mincing each other at FIFA over here. And I'm sitting back here just supporting my boys, you know? Yeah. Yeah.
One, two, check.
Welcome back to my evangelical Christian sermon. Today, we're going to talk about the power of
A sharp minor.
Of leaving yourself vulnerable.
G minor.
You are here watching the greatest of all time to ever do it. The sexiest, the finest, the fittest, the craziest, the most handsomest. Accompanied by the second most everything I just said.
Wow.
Hit my hand, man. Hit it. Give me some love. Yeah, okay. Yeah, you know what it is. You know what it is. It's like, we'll never be June. Exclusively produced by Prodigy Stapes. Keys handled by Wesley Snipes behind the camera.
Yeah.
Hey! Yeah, the amount of effort that was in there. Anyways, people, make sure to drink your water. And listen to this project religiously because music is religion. And cut.
Feel young, but I don't wanna live forever. Wanna feel young, but I don't wanna live forever. Can we hold hands, chasing down the
light? I think the whole hands.
We hold hands, chasing down the light. I wanna feel young, but I don't wanna live forever. Wanna feel young, but I don't wanna live forever.
Chasing down delight.
Yeah. Can we hold hands, chasing down the light? I wanna feel young, but I don't wanna live forever. Wanna
live forever. Wanna feel young, but I don't wanna live forever. Can we?
Do we have the whole house chasing down?
Yeah, where
did we do? We did it. It's the first we should.
Yeah, it's the first one.
Yeah. Can we hold hands chasing down the light?
What's up, good people of South Africa?
What?
We just finished making a hit.
Hits.
I love myself.
What time
are
we doing
tomorrow, though? I have no idea, though. Playing FIFA until the morning light comes out, though. Amazing.
Work hard and play hard.
Yeah, we played a bit of harder than we...
We played a bit harder than we worked, though.
Wesley,
it wasn't balanced.
Yay. One win throughout this entire three session.
The December session had finished, and by this time, everything we thought was supposed to be in the project was now finally in the project. It was now a matter of driving Jiggy home, as well as Wesley, as I usually do on my Fosler drive, beginning to finish off the planning for how we're going to roll out. At this time, the project was majority done, but there were still small aspects of it still had to finish off. And that led us into the next year.
Everything has gone down. We had a session with Panelli, but it was really cool because I think us as friends, we connect really well now. And yeah, I hope that you guys, whoever listens to the project, you guys enjoy it. Man, I just want people to know that the project took us a lot of hard work to make, about 2 years, and a lot of experiences, is good, bad, and amazing, and incredibly terrible to go through, but I hope that it sparks something inside you. And the whole point of the project is just to hopefully inspire anyone who wants to do anything like me. So I hope that if you are on a journey where you want to do something like I do or be in the field that I'm in, this can be something that's a good guideline to follow. I think that if you can, follow your dreams. I think work towards them. They're incredibly difficult, but you'll be happy you did it. And I think that, find role models. Find people who do exactly what you want to do. And let them inspire you. And follow that route. But before my seatbelt thing kills me of annoyance, I just want to say that thank you to my friends who come and record with me. Who come and record me. They're really smart guys. Really big nerds. And I dedicate this to them to say thank you for always... for trusting me to make sure that I can lead us to where we need to go, or I can be an instrument to the orchestra of the blessings that we want to achieve. So to Lihle and Banele, honestly, shout out to you guys for what you've done for me, and to much more success. Alright, now let me get the fuck out of Fosler.
If the Grammys can be corrupt, why can't we? You know what I'm saying?
I'm looking at it.
Hi guys, I'm out of the boys.
How much is the iced coffee? And do they sell iced coffee here at McDonald's in South Africa? How much is the iced coffee? I know jobs. Yeah. After the project jobs,
yeah,
we can focus on the music videos where we can do the fan and the ideas for choice and all that other stuff. Like as a post-push, like a post-rollout type thing.
Panelli, what day is it today?
It's the last day.
Hey, look at the camera when you're speaking to the fans, dog. What day is it today?
It's Sunday.
Yes.
Sunrise. I want to do one of them womp womps. You know what I mean? Womp, womp, womp.
Yes sir, we got you.
That's low finesse coming out of your dog.
Yeah. Put that white people back.
Excuse me, let me steal this seat for a couple of seconds.
See, remember when I said that white people shit? Now he's colonizing my chair, dog. Hey. It all starts as a wave. Let's pee, let's
pee. Shites!
You are being recorded.
Hi guys. I meant to light. I don't wanna know.
Oh, cheer. What time is it, Lisha?
It is currently 5 a.m. and we are just out here. Just look at this beautiful sun. It's beautiful. We've been up all night.
It's weird to say, but real dreams are fiction. Real dreams are things that we write on a piece of paper and hope to to live one day, and then when they happen, we rarely ever tend to notice. Everything we're living now is stuff that I wrote down on a piece of paper on a notepad somewhere. Will never be June is a dreamer's defiance. Because standing on this balcony at 5 a.m. in the morning watching the sunrise felt like us watching a new dawn. Whether this is a big moment or a small one all depends on timing. Will never be June is a page in a book. I urge you to read it, experience it, and by the end of the page, I hope you be brave to turn it. Real dreams are fiction, and the ink is endless for those who are prepared to write themselves a story. Inspired by the story of Sigurd, a man who sought to destroy the dragon of fear, we've climbed the mountain to slay the beast and free the part of ourselves we thought we'd never meet. We'll never be June as us. Us reflected in you.
Like,
the music already has to be dope. That's something that we don't need to think about. You know what I mean? Music.
What's up, Lee?
Music.
What's going on?
It's a prerequisite.
I'm here with my bestie.
So it's not a conversation to even be had.
It was the day before Will Never Be June dropped, and we went to Rover's listening party. I can say there was a lot on my mind on expectations of what's gonna happen, but there was just a lot of relief because we had been working on this project for 3 years, so it was a good thing that it's finally coming out. And all I had in my heart was, I hope that people enjoyed it.
Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, the tape is released, and it's kind of awkward now because we're here. You know what? The idea I had in my head was, I'll do this one when I'm... Never mind, I won't. Tape is out, nigga. Thank you. I'm gonna watch that shit. Yeah.